guys. Let's say some things about VIR. It took me 3 years to develop this electronic. At first time, I wanted something really small because what it matters on cigarettes is the length and the width, the size in general. But when VIR was ready, I wanted more things. I wanted to make it look like a mechanical. And then I wanted to remove electronic part easy. I wanted to make something healthy. I wanted to not disturb the user by forcing him to know what kind of wire he has to put on it. Then I wanted to stop the burnt taste and other things. Of course, all these things need a lot of development, and that's why I never came up with an electronic circuit. Now we managed to make something that I am proud of, and something that is complete. We can go further with this in, on the next electronics, but it will have minor features. The serious features, to my opinion, are all of them on VIR. I think that VIR is an electronic circuit, circuit that gives you everything you need and everything that is needed for a finally healthy vaping. We can see together all the functions, the ease of use, and of course the healthy vaping it offers to a vaping community. And I say that again because the final purpose on vaping is our health. That's why we stop smoking. I have write all the specifications in a notepad. We can see them one by one. They are the same specifications you read on the first video about VIR. And I will try to explain you and to show you at the same time how it works and how what can you do with VIR, its menu and all these things. First of all, we said that the electronic doesn't allow you to vape acrolein that is poisoning your body. We know that acrolein is produced at 290 Celsius degrees. So VIR can go up to 280 Celsius degrees because we have a currency of 5 Celsius degrees. So I didn't want to reach the point where glycerin produce acrolein. So we will vape, but the maximum we can vape is at 280 Celsius degrees. I can't show you that now because there's no display on the VIR. But even if there was a display, what you read on the display, it's maybe not true. You have to have it in your hands and to vape it to understand and the temperature that you vape. A screen may say everything it likes, but the fact is that it has to be real. The second one is that the electronic knows when your atomizer is dry or bad fitted, and it will drive the atomizer to produce less smoke, and in a while it will stop functioning and it will give you a LED signal. That way you always know that it's time to refill or open the liquid control on GG atomizers. We can make here, first of all, you see some wires. This is a stainless steel wire at 0.4. It's a fat one. Here we have 0.20. Let's make the focus. And here is 0.31.5. Here we have titanium, 0.32, and titanium grade 1, 0.25. will make a resistance on Telemachos at 1-0. We will make with titanium 0.25, and we will see how Viris behaves and how it starts vaping and the functions of it. I will cut maybe the video. There is no reason to spend time making the wire. Let's make a wire at 2.5 millimeters screwdriver. First of all, you have to know that threads must not touch each other. That's a serious part of VIR, because it will not read well your wire, and also you may have a burnt taste too. So let's make the wire. Let's see if threads touch each other. I think it's okay. And let's put some wick. People that use Telemachos, I have to say that it's not about VIR, but for the best results on Telemachos, you leave 1 millimeter the wick from both sides, and you make the wick a little fatter of channels to cover all the channel like this, and it's okay. Let's put some wick. Excuse me. Some liquid, put the mouthpiece, and let's start working with VIR. I put VIR on a Steregon for now. I will change the battery, make a fresh one, because it is almost empty.
First of all, when we put battery, let's start to see how VIR is working. You put a battery, and when you put the battery, the green LED is open and it is waiting for your response. The waiting is 13 seconds. Why the green LED opens? It opens and it is waiting for you to put an atomizer on it. If you don't put an atomizer for 13 seconds, it will lock. You saw that it locked, you saw the blue light. I will explain later this function and why we have to wait, because we have to auto-detect atomizer. You have 13 seconds to put the same atomizer on VIR. If you take it off and you want to make adjustments, or you want to refill, some atomizers don't accept refilling by the small cap on the top, and they need to get unscrew it from the mod. So while you unscrew your atomizer, you have 13 seconds to put the same atomizer here, because you want to keep the same adjustments you have done. Or to say it better, because electronic has read one specific atomizer. If you take off this atomizer and more than 13 seconds pass, then this atomizer will be lost from VIR. VIR will have to read it again from the start. So, or you will wait 13 seconds and you have on 13 seconds to put the same atomizer on VIR, or you will lock the device so you don't have the limit of 13 seconds. You have any time you like to make the adjustments or to refill to the existing atomizer. Anyway, we will see this later in a better way. Okay, VIR is locked. Now we put atomizer on it and we want to VIR to auto detect the atomizer. What is auto detection? Auto detection is a function. First of all, VIR works with two wires, titanium grade 1 and stainless steel. I use stainless steel 304. We can use maybe 316. I haven't tested that, but I think that from tables that I found on internet that they have the same behavior. What is auto detection? Let's say that you carry with you titanium and stainless steel, and you don't know what is what. There's no problem with VIR, because you will put any wire you like in any length you like and in any width you like, and the VIR will auto detect your wire. This is a very special function, a really difficult one. It took me a month to develop it, but it is a new technology, a real technology, a technology that doesn't exist, to my opinion, anywhere. At least that's what I know, because I searched the internet about this and I didn't find anything. Auto detection of a wire is a very special feature that exists on VIR. Now, let's start the auto detection. As you saw, I made the resistance, I put the wick, I put some liquid on it, and now I will start the auto detection function. We will unlock the device, and after that, VIR will start auto detection automatically. I will take off the mouthpiece to show you that during auto detection, your atomizer will work at a very low voltage, trying to auto detect your wire. Let's unlock it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Blue LED blinks and auto detection starts. Auto detection starts automatically, as I told you before, and the red LED will start blinking. Auto detection, the time for the auto detection depends on your atomizer. If your atomizer is hot, we have to take the right measurements, and VIR tries to take the right measurements, even if it is hot, but it takes more time. So if your atomizer is hot, it will take about 2 or 2.5 minutes. If it is cold, it will take 1 or 1.5 minutes. the red light stop. Let's see what it found. I think that battery doesn't make a good contact, excuse me. It's because a Steregon is not made the right way for a... It doesn't have the proper cap. And I saw that the red light just stopped because battery didn't have the right contact. Also, battery has a magnet to fit on a Steregon, so the detection just stopped. Let's wait. You see the atomizer is vaping. You see some smoke. It is not a function. While we are waiting for the auto detection, I want to tell you that if it found titanium grade 1, an orange light will stay open and for about 3 seconds. And if it found stainless steel, an open blue light will stay open. Also, you can see what kind of wire you have on your on the VIR. At any time, you can unscrew battery and screw it again. If you do that, you will see that you will see the color that will stay open, and you will remember what kind of wire you have inside. Let's see. You saw that. An orange light open. Let's see it again, and that's why you can see at every time what kind of wire you have inside. Unscrew battery, screw it again, and you see the purple light that the orange light that opened. That means that we put inside titanium grade 1, and that's true because we put titanium grade 1 at this width. Now, if we push the button, atomizer will start working. You see that we push the button, atomizer works very little, and if we leave the button, a green light is blinking. That means that atomizer has no liquid on it. And as you saw, the threads didn't get red hot and burn your wick and your wire, of course, and doesn't oxidize your wire. So let's put again. Let's see, first of all, in what step we are. Excuse me. 1, 2, 3. Now we are at the maximum step, that is 280 Celsius degrees, and let's see what will happen if we push the button. At that time, watts are really big. We are talking about 25 or more watts, and if we push the button without wick, like it is now, without liquid, as it is now our wick, then the wire has to go red hot. And of course, the wick has to be burned. Let's see what will happen. As you see, nothing happened. The wire started working for about 200 milliseconds. And VIR showed that you didn't have liquid on your wick. And the green light started blinking. Let's see it again. Okay, now let's put some liquid and see what will happen when atomizer has liquid on it. Let's see now. You see that it's working. And because the liquid we put was a little, the liquid the liquid is over, and when liquid is over, when liquid gets over, the green light started blinking again. Let's see again. Now it vaped less because it shows a very small liquid quantity. Now let's push the button, and at the same time we will put a liquid on the resistance. That way we will let VIR working all the way, because it will always see liquid on the wick. You see it's working while I put liquid, and that's what will happen when you have your atomizer closed and the wick is fitted with liquid all the time. In a while, it will stop functioning because I stopped putting liquid. Let the button, push it again until all the liquid is over. You saw a red light that it opened after 2 seconds after I push the button. Let's see it again. This red light that is opening after 2 seconds and it stays open 1 second. Means that you vape in a temperature lower than your setup, because one battery can't work at a so high temperature. It can't give the right power. It can't give so much current. Push it again. You see that the liquid is over, so VIR doesn't work because it sees that your wick is doesn't have liquid on it. The green light that is blinking shows you that you are out of liquid, and you can see it at any time while you vape, something that you can't really do with a screen, because if you can't vape, you have to look at the screen to see if something is happening. Now you see it in real, so while you vape, you have the light blinking in front of your eye, and you always know that you are out of liquid. Okay, we'll show what is happening if there's no liquid on the wick. Let's see the third function, as you saw on the first video for VIR. And the third function says, electronic knows when a burnt taste is coming and stops it. That way, you avoid a disgusting taste and the most serious, a permanent damage to your lungs. Why a burning taste is coming? A burning taste is coming because the temperature on inside your atomizer is very big, and it comes big because it comes big when you don't have liquid on the wick that reduces temperature on your wick. The limit of the temperature we put in every step, or to say it better, the working temperature is always lower than the burn taste of your liquid and your wick. The steps on temperature as 100 is 160, then we go 180, 200, 220. 240, 260, and 280 is the final temperature. So a burn test is coming when the temperature is going higher than 280 Celsius degrees, and we avoid this, of course, because in every step we work in always in low temperatures, lower temperatures than this limit. Let's see. Fourth, electronic doesn't let your wick get burned. This is another result of temperature control, because the wick has especially cotton. It starts get burning after 280 Celsius degrees. So we don't have any problem at any step, especially when we don't can't go, especially when we can't go further than 280 degrees, because we don't reach the limit of the temperature where cotton is starting getting burned. On lower steps, there's no problem, of course, because they are lower than the final temperature of the VIR. The fifth is that the electronic doesn't allow your wick to get black. Of course, it will not get black if it is not get burned. The sixth is that electronic protects your wire from a very dangerous oxidation, because it doesn't let it go red hot. As you saw, I push the button even if I was in the higher step on VIR, on temperature. And you saw that nothing happened on your wire or your wick. The wire can't go red hot, and the wick doesn't get burned. Also, this temperature of 280 degrees Celsius degrees is the limit for the acrolein. We can't go, as I said before, higher, because acrolein starts produced, and that's exactly what we want to avoid. The seventh is that the flavor depends a lot on temperature. Electronic checks 1,000 times per second the liquid on your wick, so you always have the same taste even during the inhale. The flavor stays exactly the same even if you run out of liquid. Why this is happening? First of all, the flavor that depends a lot on temperature, we know that already. So what electronic does? Electronic wants to keep the temperature at a specific level. So even if you run out of liquid, even the smallest liquid on your wick will be baked at the same temperature. It's exactly the same if we had a lot of liquid on the wick. So even if the liquid is in small quantity or in big quantity, the temperature of the vaping liquid is always exactly the same. So your taste doesn't change while you vape, even if you run out of liquid. VIR can vape parallel coils with the same advantages it has with a single coil. There's no reason to change again the atomizer, but on atomizers that can take dual coils or triple coils or more, I can't do that on Telemachos. The VIR will work exactly as it has to work, because it will control temperature on all the wires you have put on your atomizer. The resistance have to be almost the same. There's no problem if you put the resistance at 1 ohm at one coil and 1.1 to the other, or 0.9. But we will have an issue if we put the resistance 1 ohm to the one wire and 0.5. Not a problem with burn taste and all this, but the problem that the one wire will vape better and the other wire will not vape. It will not burn your wick or your wire. You will not be able to vape with two wires in real, because the most work will go, the most job will go to the one wire. 9 writes that especially on GG atomizers that have liquid control, you can control the quantity of your smoke via mouthpiece. That is real, and you understand it easily, because let's say that you want to vape a small quantity of liquid at a specific temperature because you want to have less smoke. VIR will work with a small quantity of liquid and it will produce less smoke. I will show you now what I mean. And let's say that you want to vape with more smoke at a specific temperature without increasing the temperature. What we knew until now was that if we want to have more smoke, we have to increase watts and or volts, and to have a smoke that is hotter and of course better, thicker, and in general more smoke. This is not happening with VIR because at a specific, let's say that we vape at 200 Celsius degrees. If we have small liquid, we will have small smoke. If we let atomizer be fitted better, and this is why I was saying, I was talking about the atomizers that have liquid control, you open the mouthpiece and you fit your wick better, you will have much more smoke because electronic sees excess liquid on the wick and tries to eliminate it, so it will go again to the temperature we set on with our button. The more liquid that goes on your wick makes temperature get lower. Electronic tries to make it higher, to bring it at the level we set with our button, and that means that it gives more power, more current, and the result is, of course, much more smoke. I can show you this. Let's vape it. Let's go 3 steps lower to be sure that, because we don't have a tank and we want to be sure that the electronic will not stop functioning because it will not see liquid. Okay, we are at step 3 steps down. We are at 220. You see the smoke now that I started, and you will see the smoke a little later. You see the smoke is reducing without having a burn taste because electronic sees that you don't have enough liquid. So without a burn taste, the smoke is lower, and in a while it will stop functioning at all because it will not find any liquid at all. Let's go one step more, so the liquid will finish easier and quicker, to see what will happen. You see how VIR controls the liquid, controls the temperature depending on the liquid on your atomizer. I want to let you see the LED too. You see now no smoke, and when I release the button, you see that the green light is blinking because the liquid on your atomizer is so small that the temperature, if VIR continues vaping, the temperature will raise more than what we set with the button, and it stops functioning at all. If I try again, I will take for less than a second some smoke and it will stop again. You saw that the smoke was very little. were very small, and the green light is blinking. Now, if at from that position we are now, we put some liquid. I put 3 drops. It will vape for a while and it will stop again. You also saw that in the temperature we vape, the red light didn't open because the battery can manage so small quantity of liquid, and it doesn't send so big a current to the atomizer, and that's why the blue, the red light doesn't open. If we put the temperature in a higher level, the red light will open, but of course it will stop functioning before the red light opens because we are in a very high temperature. Let's do it. Let's see what will happen with so small quantity of liquid inside the atomizer at the higher level of temperature. It vape a little, but before the red light opens, to tell us that the battery can't handle so big temperature. The green lights that we don't have liquid were quicker than the red light. Okay, let's go where we were, 2 steps less. It keeps vaping, VIR is controlling the temperature. You see the smoke gets less and less and less, until no smoke is produced, and it will stop functioning, or it will lock after the time we set for locking. Let the button and start again. Now it stopped. Okay. Let's see the 10. 10 says that electronic can control the temperature of your smoke. Cold smoke doesn't mean less smoke anymore. It's exactly what I told you before. If we vape at, for example, 200 Celsius degrees, if we have a bad fitted atomizer, or an atomizer that has less liquid on it, or an atomizer without a liquid control, it will vape. And if the temperature is high enough, the smoke will be less. But with GG atomizers, for example, we can open the mouthpiece, so more liquid will go to the wick, and that means that the more liquid on the wick, the temperature will go lower and lower and lower. While VIR is trying to keep the temperature in a specific level, means that it will send so much current that the smoke will be very big at that point, but it will stay cold. And when I say cold as it can be at 200 Celsius degrees. But it will be much colder than if we had set the temperature at 240 or 60 Celsius degrees. I'm sure that maybe you don't understand well all these things now that you see the video. I'm trying to do my best, but you will see VIR in action when you have it in your hands and understand what I'm talking about. 11 says that electronic will make your battery last more because it always gives the exact current for the exact amount of liquid on your atomizer. That's true, of course, because let's see what we were doing on VATS. On VATS, we push the button and we vape. Taste was not always the same because the current was much more than it had to be to burn the liquid on the wick. Sometimes we had a burn taste, especially when we had when the VATS were very high. We set the VATS at a very high level. the electronic part, a VW device will give a current exactly the same all the time, but the liquid on the wick didn't want so much a current to vape in the right way. Now, what we do with VIR is to give the exact current for the exact amount of liquid, and that is something that helps us to let battery give less current if we have less liquid on the atomizer, and that makes battery gives always the right current and makes battery lasts more. 12 says that there is no need anymore to measure how fat your wire is. Electronic understands the width of your wire and it will vape exactly the same as if you had put inside your atomizer a thinner or a fatter wire. Why this is happening? VIR, first of all, knows the width of the wire. Even if it doesn't... let's say different. Electronic tries to keep the temperature at a specific level. So, even if you put a thinner or a fatter wire, electronic knows from the auto detection function what is your wire and its width, and it will send the right current for the specific width of your wire. So keeping the temperature on a thin wire or on a fat wire at the same level means that you will have the same vaping experience. Your liquid will taste the same, your smoke will be the same, and the heat will be the same, etc. There's no need, 13 says that there's no need anymore to measure your resistance. All wires will vape the same. This is happening exactly for the same reason as 12, because VIR has found your wire from the auto detection function and knows exactly what it has to do to vape 1 ohm exactly the same as 1.5 ohm and exactly the same as 2 ohms. So, while you making your resistance, there is no need anymore to measure your resistance to put it on a device, on a VIR, especially on VIR, because VIR will see exactly your resistance, your wire, your the length and the width and the kind of the wire, and it will vape at the same temperature, exactly the same as it was vaping before. Fourteen says that electronic knows when your atomizer is overfluted and it will give the right power to burn the exact liquid. This is a temperature result again, because if your atomizer is overfluted, as we said before, and your wire will come colder because more liquid is on the wire, VIR will send the right current to keep the temperature at a specific level, and at the same time to burn the exact the excess liquid on your wick. 15 says that electronic understands when you don't inhale and it stops functioning after some seconds. This is happening on big steps at the two final steps, because the temperature is very high and we don't want to have a burnt taste at any time. What I mean is this, let's go one step before the higher highest level of temperature, and let's put some one two drops. Okay, if we start vaping, you will see that one or two drops were a very small quantity to make for VIR to let atomizer work, because we would have a burnt taste. But if we continue inhaling, let's do it again. Okay, but if we start inhaling, electronic understands that we inhale because the temperature comes lower and tries to keep it at the same level, so it will work much more than if we don't inhale at all. For example, We need some more liquid because the drops are a very small quantity. Okay. And let's try to vape. You see the blue light. If we start inhaling continuously, you saw that the green light started blinking again, but the smoke was much more before VIR make atomizer stop functioning. Let's see it again. We make a regular inhale. It starts blinking. Let's see it again. Or if we take a regular inhale, as you saw, or if we push the button, you see how quickly VIR stops atomizer working, except we inhale, we take a direct inhaling, which is long and continuously inhaling. As you saw, the LED, even if we had a very small quantity of liquid, the LED didn't open, because it shows that the resistance it needs to send a much current to keep the resistance at the specific temperature. But if we push it without inhaling, the green light will start blinking. Next is 16 and says that electronic understands the kind of wire you put in your atomizer and it will give you a color LED signal, something that I showed you when I start the video, depending on your wire. Titanium grade 1 is orange and stainless steel wire is light blue. I will show you at the end of the video what will happen if we put a different wire that is stainless steel, and you will see that if we put the stainless steel, it will identify the wire and it will give you a light blue signal. We must not forget to do that, so I will mark it on the notepad. Now, see, 17 says that all other electronics stop functioning if your battery can't give you the necessary power, and you have to adjust manually the watts by reducing them one by one, trying to find at what point your electronic will start working again. VIR reads the difference that VIR, the function that VIR gives you is that it reads the power that battery can give at any time and keeps working, giving you a LED signal that you vape lower than your setup. It was the red light that is opening 2 seconds after you start inhaling, and it will stay open for 1 second. That LED shows you that you vape lower, but VIR, as you saw, it doesn't stop functioning. It is vaping even if you are at the final step of the temperature. You vape, of course, lower, and that's what the red light shows you, but it doesn't stop functioning. I mean that there is no reason to push the button to go lower to still to keep vaping. This function is automatically, and that way you can vape automatically at lower setup without the need of manual adjustments and pointless ones, because even if you go at a lower step, what is happening with temperature? Even if you go to a low step and you think that battery can give the necessary power, that's not always true. You must stop thinking with volts and watts. Why? Because let's say that we vape in with a fresh battery at the 10th step. You think that, of course, a battery will handle the power, but that's not true, because if much liquid goes to your wick, the current that the battery must give is so big that even if you are at a low step of temperature, the battery has to give so much current that it can't handle it. So maybe on the 10th step, for example, you will see the red light. Okay, let's see that in action, and I will put the other battery that is almost empty and see what will happen. Excuse me, I put a magnet because I don't have the right cap for a Stericon, so I put a magnet to have the proper contact. You see the purple light, that means that we have titanium grade one. And let's see the step we are. We are at the highest step of temperature. Let's see if it vapes. Now, you see that it vapes, and the red light opened to show you that you vape in a lower temperature. This battery, let's measure the battery to see how low it is, and in reality, it wouldn't be able at all to vape at that temperature. The volts of the battery are 3.5. You understand that a battery at 3.5 volts can't vape at 280 Celsius degrees, but they're still functioning at a low temperature automatically, and there is no reason to change your battery. And electronic, if your battery, for example, another electronic shows you that you need to change your battery, it stops functioning. Something that it will not happen with VIR. If you don't have a battery with you, or if you want to vape at a lower temperature, all these are made automatically. Let's see that again. It still vapes without the problem. The 18 says that on high steps, 13 and 14, GG Electronic knows the time you inhale and gives more power to produce more smoke. I showed you that before, and at high steps with less liquid, when we took a direct inhaling, the atomizer was working. When we just pushing the button, the atomizer stops working because it shows less liquid on your atomizer. 19 says that all the above features are in real time. You see that electronic, as I said before, electronic checks 1,000 times per second the liquid on your atomizer, and always and exactly at the right time it stops functioning, or it shows you a LED signal of what is happening inside your atomizer. The red LED shows you that you vape lower, the green light shows you that you don't have liquid, and these are the two minor LEDs that you will see while you vaping. There are some other LEDs I will show you, but this is the most serious and the LED that you will often see while you vape. And 20 knows, finally, you know at what temperature your atomizer works. That's true, because you know that every step is 20 Celsius degrees. The first step is 160, the next 180, 200, and up to 280 Celsius degrees. after the release of some other temperature control devices, I found two more advantages on VIR. I never thought that this would be advantages, but anyway, after the release of those electronics, I saw that you can, first of all, with VIR, use your atomizers on other modes. That's why, that's because the atomizers that VIR can control are regular atomizers with regular resistances, like the resistances we were always making, that were 0.5 ohm up to 2 ohms. That means that you can take your atomizer from VIR and put it to another device. And the 22 is that you have excellent accuracy on your temperature because resistance on your atomizer is big. Very small resistances demand very good atomizers and very good contacts that are impossible to be made by any modder or any user. Only on a lab we can make a so good atomizer resistance combination. So atomizers that use titanium and SS are the ideal ones for our applications, because if we don't have accuracy on the temperature, then we don't have real protection. The only we will have is a very about temperature control. And also, big resistances don't demand big current that will make your mod feel very hot, like a furnace. Now, let's don't forget. We must not forget to show you the stainless steel function and the light that is opening during the auto detection function. But before this, let's read again the notepad that says that electronic works only with titanium grade 1 and stainless steel. That are the only biocompatible materials. So if electronic detects nichrome or canthal, it will not vape it at all. If your electronic detects nichrome or canthal or any other wire, it will show you a purple light. So the grade 1 is orange, titanium grade 1. The stainless steel is light blue, and the canthal is purple. The wires that can be auto-detected are 0.2 millimeters up to 0.6 millimeters. There's no reason to put a bigger wire, because bigger wires can't be caught from the bolts we use on atomizers. They are very fat. Now, let's make another wire and then to show you how it works with stainless steel. And then I will take off the PCBA to show you some things on it. I will take 1 minute. Before that, I want to show you what is happening with your atomizer if it is auto-detected like this. It is already auto-detected and you want to refill it, or you want to make something on it. I don't know what you want to do on an atomizer and why you want to take it off from VIR. Look, take off the atomizer. The green light is opening to show you, waiting for your response. If you screw again the atomizer, the green light will stop and you will be able to still vape your atomizer. VIR keeps on its memory your atomizer and your settings, and you will be able to vape. Now, the green light is opening to give you time and to let you make your adjustments, and of course to remind you that you have 13 seconds to put the same atomizer again on VIR. The first electronic I made didn't have that time. If you were taking off the atomizer, the VIR was locking immediately and it was losing your atomizer. Now I give you time to do that. Okay. If you think that 13 seconds are not enough time, it's not enough time to make adjustments or to refill your atomizer, what you can do is to lock the device. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Device is locked, and now you can take off your atomizer. and spend as much time as you want to make anything on it, except of course changing the resistance because it's a new atomizer and it needs auto detection again. So if you want to use the same atomizer, you put it again. You unlock the device and your atomizer is still working. Excuse me, take VIR. Okay. I left these 13 seconds with the green light open to send you a signal that the atomizer is waiting, and while you see the signal, you have to take action. The better would be anytime you want to take off your atomizer, to lock it. Lock VIR and take off your atomizer and do anything you want on it. But in case you forgot to lock it, and you take it off, because this will happen to you, I'm sure, and the reason is that we are used to take off atomizers and put another atomizer on your mod, on our mods. We have to be careful to lock the VIR every time you want to take off your atomizer. But I give you 13 more seconds in case you forget to lock it, because we always forget it. I forget to lock the device enough times, so I give 13 seconds and a LED signal to remind you that you have to lock the device, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, lock, or if you want to put another atomizer and you want to make a new setup, so the auto detection function must start again. What we have to do is take off our atomizer while it is unlocked, because we don't want to put the same atomizer, and wait 13 seconds until the green light stops. When the green light stops, it means that VIR forgot your atomizer and you have to auto-detect the same atomizer again. You have no reason for that, or to put a new atomizer, a new setup. Now we will make a new setup to show you how the stainless steel wire behaves on VIR and the LED that will open when it auto detects stainless steel. Let's put a fat wire this time, that is 0.4. This is a very fat wire. The resistance that VIR can vape are 0.45 up to 2.2 ohms. So, because our wire is fat this time, I have to make it long enough to achieve this resistance. Let's measure it, but No, there is no reason to measure it because even if the wire is lower, VIR will auto detect the wire, but you will not be able to vape it. So in that case, VIR will not vape it, and it will give you 10 quick red lights. That means a short circuit. I will show you in a while. Let's see for now the auto detection for a stainless steel wire. Let's screw better the bolts. You have to know that VIR is working excellent if you have nice contacts, tight bolts with the wires. I think the resistance is okay. Let's push it a little. Put some wick. I leave, as you see, 1 millimeter. Of wick from both sides, 1 millimeter here, out of the channels, 1 millimeter here. And let's start the auto detection function. We screw atomizer. Okay, and we unlock the device so that auto detection will start automatically. 1, 2, 3.5, and the auto detection is starting by the blue, with the blue LED, the red light blinking. Let's wait to see the color that will come. This video was a little rushed because you people wanted me to show you as soon as possible what VIR can do. The auto detection function is not finished yet. It needs a little more software. So if we don't see a blue light, an open blue light, it's because the software is not exactly ready. There's no problem at all, of course. The auto detection function will work exactly as it has to work. Let's see the notepad to see if I have to tell you something more. Yes, I will show you how the PCBA electronic circuit is made. What I have to tell you is that it is mechanical look, as you see. There's no display that can break or anything else. And of course, I wrote that it's not only uses, but it blocks your view. I wrote this because screen is only to show you, to my opinion, in what temperature you vape something that you don't really want. Because even if you know, even if you see that you vape at 200 and you're not satisfied, you will go higher. So we don't need the temperature we want to vape. We need the specific temperature we like to vape. So even if we know that we are at 200, or if we don't know that we're at 200. What we have to know is to what temperature we like to vape by increasing or decreasing by the pattern of the VIR. Also, on a display, you can't see that you vape lower. While on VIR, you see the red light opening. Also, you can see if you run out of liquid, that on VIR, you see it directly because the green light starts blinking and it is in front of your eye. All the other information, to my opinion, are just for fun, to know at what voltage you vape, you may see on the screen, or at what current is passing through your wire. Well, VIR has some more functions, that is working atomizer check. I have to show you what is happening when an atomizer doesn't work, or if your atomizer is shorted, or if your atomizer have lower resistance than the resistance of the working resistance of VIR. There is a lock mode. Lock mode doesn't work here because I have set it in a very high level. I didn't want the VIR stops functioning while I'm making this video, but I'm thinking that the cutoff mode has to be at about 15 or 20 seconds. I will see what I will do about this. You saw the lock mode, 5 times the device is locked. We will make, as I said, 15 or 20 seconds cutoff. We have short circuit protection, I will show you. Over discharge battery protection, battery goes up to 3.3 volts and then stops functioning. I don't know if I have a battery like this now, so much discharge, but it works up to 3.3. We have thermal monitoring. The electronic will stop functioning if the temperature inside it goes up, goes more than 60 Celsius degrees. Excuse me, I had notepad in front of me and I didn't show the light. And if I want to see what the VIR auto detected, I unscrew the battery, screw it again, and as you see, the open blue light opened. That means that it auto detected the stainless steel wire. Now, as I said before, there's no reason to know what wire you put there, what the width of a wire, and what the length of wire, that means the resistance. You just put a wire on VIR and you vape it. Now, let's see the working atomizer check. If VIR doesn't detect an atomizer or an atomizer that doesn't have a wire on it, what will happen? It will happen what I told you. We don't have atomizer. So, a green light will open. I don't want to lose for now the settings, so I will screw it again. So, if the device is locked and you put an atomizer, you unlock the device and your device is shorted, excuse me, not shorted, doesn't have any wire on it. The green light will open, it will stay open for 13 seconds and then it will lock. That means that it didn't find atomizer. But if it finds an atomizer, look, I screw the right atomizer. So now VIR found an atomizer and didn't lock as if it would do if he hadn't found an atomizer. It stops the green light because it found the right atomizer. What is a short circuit protection? Let's short the device. We will put a screwdriver to both poles to short the device and push the button. You see a red light that is blinking continuously and quickly to show you that you had a short. You see it? Okay. Nine is reverse battery protection. Reverse battery protection, you see now that VIR is working, and if we take off the battery and put it on the other side, take off the magnet, of course. You will not have magnet on your battery. This battery has this plastic outside. If we put the battery to the opposite side, VIR will not work. As you see, nothing opened, nothing is pushed. Let's put it the right way again. Excuse me, I didn't put the magnet. Sorry, but I don't have the right tube for a steering gun. Reverse battery protection, we saw that. Over discharge battery protection, I don't have a discharge battery to show you, but I said it will stop functioning the battery at 3.3 volts. Thermal monitoring, I can't show you that too, because the electronic has to be very hot to stop functioning, something that is happening very, very rare. 12 says that the power range is 2 to 25 watts with one battery and 2 to 35 watts with two 3.7 volt batteries. I did it like this because if I let one battery to go up to 30 watts, your battery will last so a small time that you will not be very happy. One battery, to my opinion, these batteries that are 18650 must work up to 25 watts, and two batteries can work more. 13 says that you always know at what temperature level you are. Of course, you know that. Let's see why. Because it's on the menu of VIR. Let's say that you want to measure at what step you are. Steps start from 160, so the lowest step is 160 Celsius degrees. You want to see at what level you are. You mean that the LED will count from 20 Celsius degrees up to the Celsius degrees you are. Let's see, let's see. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. We are at the highest level. 13, I made it like, I wanted to make it easy for you. 13 is 13. If we, 2 times 13, I don't know exactly the words in English. 2 times 13 is 28. So we are at 280 Celsius degrees. If we go some steps lower, let's measure again the steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9. 9 means that if we double the number of blinking, we are going to 18, so we are at 180 Celsius degrees. That's for a very quick measurement without trying to add from 160, that is the lower point, how many blinks they are for. So 4 times 20 is another 80, so 160 and 80 is this. That would be difficult. Now we know that we double the counts, the blinks of the LED, and we know exactly at what temperature we are. You can stop LED flashes by pushing the button one time. Let's say that we don't have liquid. Let's vape. Let's wait for the green blinks to start. So you see that while it was blinking, I pushed the button one time to stop it. A function that for people that don't want to wait until all the blinkings of the LED stops, for example, for the soft circuit, for the no liquid inside the atomizer, etc. Let's do it again. Push it one time and the blinking stops. Of course, it remembers your last setup. Even if you put off atomizer and the device gets locked and it forgot your atomizer and your atomizer needs and auto detection again, your setup is remembers your setup. So even if you put a new atomizer, your setup is okay about temperature. You will still vape at the temperature you were vaping with your previous atomizer. Resistance range is from 0.45 up to 2 ohms, depending on the temperature you vape. 18 says that atomizer doesn't work when you push the button to go to a menu. That's a serious function too, because if you push the button in your atomizer is working, it may go higher the temperature you like, because we can't control temperature while you go from a menu to a menu. So on VIR, if you go to a menu, your atomizer isn't working at all. Let's see that you, no smoke will be produced while we go to a menu. Nothing happened. Let's go to the other menu. Let's go to the locking function, and nothing is happening. Now, and 19 says that you vape exactly as you like, because even if you take very short and very quick inhales, so you push the button very quick, you will not enter to a menu. That's a reality, and I will show you what I mean right now. If you have noticed, on other electronics, if you push button really quick, they enter the menu. That's really annoying. Let's see there. Look how quick I push the button. Okay, look this. Nothing is happening, you don't enter to a menu. Even if you put two times, you still don't enter to a menu. So you will never afraid that you enter to a menu, and by still pushing the button, trying to vape, you didn't change any settings of of your settings you put at the first place. And now we can see the, even if I have shown you before, how the PCB is made. First of all, I want to tell you something about the length. It took me a very, very long time to make it so small. I have said before that I went to a lot of factories, and all the factories didn't have the ability to make a so small electronic because the PCB has blinded buried vias. It is a six-layer PCB, and it was so small that the factories didn't want to take the risk to start making something like this for me. And because we are talking about length, because some people don't understand what length means on electronics, I must tell you that this is not technology, this is a construction. Technology is when we make something like this. This is very difficult, and this is why people that make electronic on cigarettes don't bother themselves to make something small. It is really difficult, as I said. It took me a lot of time, more than 6 months, to find a factory to make this for me. This is a real technology, guys. This is the smallest circuit ever made on electronic cigarettes. It's so difficult that I don't think that I will be able to make it again. Maybe next projects, not maybe, next projects will be bigger. But this is a really miracle that I managed to do because I just wanted to do. It is, as you see, I have shown you before, it is about the width, let's put it like this to see it better, of my nail. Okay, that's about the length and the technology that VIR carries. For people that want to know the length of VIR and the length of their the cigarette that they will be able to vape with this small electronic. Another thing is that it has a mechanical button. Mechanical button means that we don't have a button, an electronic button that is small and with small springs that easily, that is made for a specific number of pushes, and it will someday get damaged permanently. We only have a small piece of metal, and that piece of metal, that is the button of button case, touches and makes the contact. Another serious advantage, to my opinion, for a so small electronic circuit that can do so much things. And as I say, said again, in a so small construction. This is, to understand better, the square millimeters of this electronic circuit is half of the smallest electronic circuit today available on e-cigarettes, and I mean for VW devices. This small circuit that can do all the things I told you, from the auto detection and the temperature control and all the other things, are fitted in this small circuit. That's for now. Thanks for watching. We will say more on forum. Bye-bye.